Greetings from Telangana Tribal Welfare Residential Degree College, both at Adilabad. This is Tekam Sayakiran and I am from BCom Computers Final Year. As a part of Best Student Lecture, I am here to deal with e-commerce. And in my presentation, you can find the meaning of e-commerce, models, features, functions. And in the last of my presentation, you can get the differences between traditional commerce and e-commerce. Let us start my topic, e-commerce. E-commerce is nothing but doing business in online. It means buying and selling goods through internet. E-commerce stands for electronic commerce. In my presentation, you can see models of e-commerce, advantages, functions, features of e-commerce. In the last, the differences between traditional commerce and e-commerce. Let us see the models of e-commerce. Models of e-commerce, we have business to business, consumer to consumer, business to consumer, consumer to business, business to enterprises, and business to government. Business to business, we have the sites like WebEx, Apple, and LinkedIn. WebEx for couriers, Apple for the technology, and the LinkedIn for social networking. Customer to customer, it means consumer to consumer, we have eBay and OLX, Uber. Business to consumer, Amazon, Myntra, many sites, etc., etc. Consumer to business, also Amazon, Myntra. Only Amazon, Flipkart. Why the Amazon is comes under B2C and C2B means here C2B the some handloom manufacturers are simply manufacture their goods and simply they do business through the sites. That's why the Amazon comes under two things, B2C and C2B. B2 enterprises means which company sites have for insurances and some health, they comes under B2 enterprises, and the buildings also comes under B2 enterprises. And B2G, which companies are making military equipments, they comes under B2G. Here we have a Tata Motors and Hindustan Motors. In our India, these companies are making electric equipments. Next, benefits of e-commerce. Here, 24/7 availability, less time consumption, more reliability, less risk. These are the benefits in e-commerce. Next, the advantages of e-commerce. Faster buying process, store and product listing creation, cost reduction, available for 24/7, affordable advertising and marketing, flexible for customers, no reach limitations, products and price comparison, faster response to buyer and the market demands. Here, what is faster buying process? Here, simply the consumer is staying at home and open the site and he search for the item which he need and which we want, and simply go through the process of buying. It will take 2 minutes. After giving location and making payment, simply we will get the product. After getting, we will simply giving our signature and getting our product. Next thing, store and product listing creation. Here, I will take one site for example. Here we have Amazon site. In that you are searching for TVs, so simply they will show only TVs because they have the disciplining of showing items. So you will and. It means the consumer will attract with the system. That's why Store and product listing creation is important and it is advantage to us. Advantage to us and them also. Cost reduction is less because there is no third party involvement between you and the site. Available for 24/7. Here we have the customer services, so you can buy anytime, anywhere. Affordable advertising and the marketing. Here we have some occasions and the festivals, so they will offer some discounts to buy their products. Flexibility of customers. You can find more flexibility for the customers in e-commerce. And no reach limitations, because we have endless companies in the site, so there is no limitations to search. Product and price comparison. Here we have many products and less price, so you can buy. Faster response to buyer and the market demands. We have customer services, so we will get faster response and you will know the market demands. Here you can find the faster buying process. Simply we are choosing the product. After our payment method, we simply get our product and simply we are giving our signature and our taking our product. Okay, the next thing, store and product listing. Here I took Amazon site and I searched for TVs, so they show only TVs. Next, cost reduction. It means less cost in the sites. Affordable advertising for the marketing. I already told, in the festival time we have discounts to buy the products. Here, the flexibility for the customers. You can see the flexibility. The customer come out and the taking the product in the door only. For this, the process is online payment, location, online tracking, product support, shopping, delivery, the site. These are the process you can find in e-commerce. Here the product supports, in for example, which product have more stars and more rating, the product supporter will help us to buy the product. And several payment methods. In several payment methods, you have many of payments methods like UPI. In UPI, you can see Google Pay, Phone Pay, Paytm, Phone Pay. And you can see credit card, debit card. Some people will afraid to do online transaction because if anybody can fraud with us, but it's wrong because some sites are doing end-to-end encryption and they process encryption process. That's why I will suggest online payment is best, because you can get discounts and some coupons for in shopping. And the functions of e-commerce. We have some functions, search engine optimization. It means which item you need, you can search for that only. And selecting product is a success to getting new product, because in nowadays many products are there, trends are came, some price differentiation, quantity. It will change by day to day, so getting new product is a success to key. Marketizing new products. In market we will get new products. Customer services, we have many customer services. Features of e-commerce, a larger market. Here you can find many sites like Amazon, Flipkart, Snapdeal. Myntra, many sites for shopping. For shopping only we have this much of sites. For mobiles, TVs, how many sites you can find? That's why a larger market means we will search in globalized. So that's why we called as e-commerce is a larger market. Customers insights through tracking and analytics. The customer is nothing to worry about his product because we have facility to analytic and tracking our product. Faster response to consumer trends and the market demands. Market will demand something like discounts, price determination. The customer needs trends, new products. Here we have many people like customer services. So we will see customer trends and market demands simply. Lower cost. Already I told there is no third party involvement, so the cost will less. More opportunities to sell your good because I already told OLX is there, eBay is there. The customer will sell their second hand item in any site. And we have many opportunities to buy the product because for the clothes we have Myntra, Trends, Reliance Trends, and for the items we have Amazon, etc. things are there. Personalized message. We have customer service centers, so there is many people in customer services, so we will get personalized messages. Traditional commerce and e-commerce. Traditional commerce is nothing but simply the person will go out for the product and he will buy and he will took the item with him. But e-commerce, simply staying at home, we are doing shopping and we will get the product. In traditional commerce, there is no available for 24/7. In e-commerce, you can find 24/7 availability. In traditional commerce, there is no customer services. In e-commerce, you can find customer services. And here, traditional commerce, there is no risk. In e-commerce, you can find the risk. And finally, I am end of my topic. Thank you so much for your patience. Have a nice day.